The Asian Pacific American Network of Oregon asks, what's your healthcare story? APANO asked a group of Asian and Pacific Islander community members.
My name is Jennifer.
My name is David.
My name is Anselmo.
My name is Andrea.
My name is Madeleine.
Questions about their unique and diverse experiences in accessing healthcare to better understand what works and what doesn't work to keep our communities healthy. APANO asks,
why is it important to talk about our health?
I guess I just learned, I mean, we all came from different backgrounds, from different places, but we kind of all have similar stories. Like, the case to case, I mean, they're different, but the general, I guess, concerns or problems are the same. So it's kind of reassuring, but at the same time, it's frustrating because there's a lot that needs to still be done. Mm-hmm.
I think for me, I was just really surprised how much I had to say, because I was just, you know, talking to people in the beginning. I'm like, I haven't really thought about healthcare that much. And, you know, if it was education, I'd be like, I don't have a lot to say. But I was surprised how much, just in our conversation, it reminded me of experiences that I've forgotten or things that I didn't think was a big deal until someone else said, yeah, that is a big deal. And it feels very validating that, like, yeah, we all are experiencing some of the things. And it just becomes everyday grind after a while that I'm like, well, yeah, you know, if I can't afford it, it's going to go on my credit card. But no, it's kind of an issue, you know, that's a problem. And so I think it is really important. And it also takes, I think, all of us coming together for us to recognize issues. Like, yeah, Anselmo and I have education, and we have, you know, that privilege of being familiar with the system in some ways to know that, and then you know, to have that discussion to recognize, yeah, like that's a huge barrier to the lack of education in our community. So it was good to put our heads together and really think about this together.
I'd have to agree with Andrea as well. I think it was good. It made me actually think about, like, different experiences that I've had and what I can categorize as being a language barrier and a culture barrier and a cost barrier. And just actually thinking of those experiences as a problem and acknowledging it instead of just saying, oh, that happened. Like, you know, it happens to everyone. But actually acknowledging that in just putting all of our heads together and being critical thinkers and analyzing everyone else's opinions and just making connections. It was really cool to see that. Besides that, I'm not sure how to change things. I like things.
Yeah. The other part I did like actually does go back to age. You know, someone my age, you think you know everything and done everything, but I really learn a lot from people who are a lot younger than I am, because I think, you know, I want to see what they're thinking, and to some degree it's the same, but yet really different, and their experiences are different, and I'm always learning. So I appreciate being invited, knowing that the people who set this up are younger, and knowing that, yeah, some old guy might have something to say, but really I feel honored to be sitting at the table with people who are in their 20s to hear, you know, your thoughts. And I can tell you're analyzing, you're not going through life just taking. So it's really good to hear, you know, and see that you are engaged, you're concerned, and hopefully with you know, your involvement, things will change for the better for all of us, you know, for your dad, your mom, your parents. For me, I'm there already. So maybe your input will help. I'll see the payoff of